As usual, the first thing we need to do when starting a new project is load our data. Our two file sources are audiobook reviews and audiobook sales. Let's connect them to Tableau. Here's the audiobook sales file. In the same folder, we also have the audiobook reviews file. We'll need both, so I'll click on Add and we'll load the other file too. In order to be able to use the information of both tables at the same time, we'll have to combine them somehow. What we want to obtain is a unique table containing information about all transactions for all audiobooks and the respective reviews left by clients whenever they chose to do so. The transaction ID column is the perfect link between the two files, as it is available in both and could serve as a common field, based on which we could link the two tables together. So, one of the main aspects we'll explore in this lesson is how to create a connection between two tables in Tableau. Please remember that we will distinguish the terms data connection and table connection. Table connection is performed by functionalities, like joining or blending. It refers to combining data from two or more data sources. Data connection, instead, represents a single source connection between Tableau and a data source, such as an Excel workbook or an SQL database. When we imported the second file, Tableau did some of the work for us in the background and created a connection between the two files. The symbol you see here is an indication we've created an inner join. Technically speaking, when creating a join, Tableau sends a query to the database. The join is implemented on the relevant tables at the database level, and the output of the operation is brought back to Tableau, where it is ready to be used for analysis. An inner join means that the two tables we've added have a field in common, and we can combine them using that field. Let me hover my mouse over the symbol. Tableau indicates that it has created an inner join using the parameter audiobook name. We don't want that. We want to link the two tables according to the transaction ID parameter, as our analysis will be focused on user sales and reviews. So I'll click on the inner join symbol, which will open the join menu. First off, let me substitute the field we use in order to create a connection between the two tables. I would like to create a connection using the transaction ID field. And here we are. Here's a preview of the table we created through an inner join and transaction ID as the primary key. As shown in the diagram, when we create an inner join between two tables, we consider their intersection, the situation where the primary key is found in both tables. To give you an example, if a person who has a given transaction ID purchased an audiobook but did not leave a review, then they won't be included in this table. An inner join would require users to have purchased an audiobook, to have left a rating, and both the date of purchase and the date when the rating was posted to be known. Basically, it contains only the rows in which we have a transaction ID, a date of purchase, a date of review, a review rating, and information regarding which was the audiobook that was purchased and rated. For example, all the cases when a person bought an audiobook but did not rate it are not considered. Do you think this information is important? Do we want to be able to understand how reviews impacted sales and whether we can see a pattern in total purchases with respect to views? Of course, we'll need this information. And if we use an inner join, we are not going to have it. Therefore, we'll need a different type of join, one that includes the information about purchases and people who did not rate an audiobook. So looking at the tiny diagram we have here, I'm going to select a left join, given that the audiobook sales file is on the left side. We want to have a table that contains information regarding audiobook purchases, all of the audiobook purchases, and the cases when people who bought these books provided a rating. and a left join is more suitable than an inner join in this case. Okay, great. In our next lesson, we'll make a check and see whether the data we've connected to Tableau is correct. This will do for now. Thanks for watching.